gentlemen, please welcome Steve Ballmer.
Under 4 meg download, and once that's complete, I get my application. So really nailing the deployment scenario for the runtime itself. Now, Chess is an interesting example here, but it's all about showing the performance of .NET. What does .NET mean in the browser? One of the challenges we've seen with Ajax is performance. There's limitations in the quality of the experience that you can build because of JavaScript performance. So what I have here is a simple chess game that I can play against the computer, but what's much more interesting is to make the browser JavaScript play against .NET. And what you'll see is .NET is about 1,000 to 1,500 times faster than browser JavaScript alone, meaning, if all things work well, .NET wins. Simultaneous streams of video coming down at once. We can take this experience full screen and have the same rich level of interactivity because of the performance of .NET and the quality of our video. Okay, let's go ahead and jump out of full screen. Now, one area we focused a lot on with Silverlight is quality. We provide content that scales from mobile devices all the way to 720p HD video on the web in full screen. We're the only technology in the market today that provides this level of quality. And Fox loved the idea of being able to provide their movie trailers for summer blockbusters in HD. So here we see a simple player branded with the Fox experience playing 720p HD content. I have some basic interactivity elements like a playlist for Die Hard and Pathfinder, other movies. Here we're seeing Fantastic Four. But when I bring this full screen, you'll see I have the same interactivity, and as you can see on the screen, very high quality media. The branding is consistent, the experience is consistent, all happening through the browser. Pretty amazing. Yeah? Yeah. You can watch the trailer for a second. No. Okay. But really, it goes broader than just media experience. It's about business models. It's about advertising on the web. Video is huge. And we need ways to monetize that and connect with customers in interesting ways. Today, you have the typical bumper ad, 15 seconds in the front, 15 seconds in the back, very easy to ignore. You want to capture user's attention, but you want to do it in the contextualized experience. So here's an example of an advertising scenario. When we have content, we're able to do a toast that overlays on top of the content, so my eyes are never taken from what I want, but I still get the branding impression. And then I can use web data like RSS to pull in real-time information and overlay that as a ticker along the bottom. You know, just like anything else, we still have the full screen experience. And one other area for interesting branding ideas is I can actually use video scaling techniques to push an ad out there, people to see, and pull it away, never breaking the content flow. Now, I can use information from users to provide very contextualized advertising in the case of video. And now Microsoft is making bets on this technology. I'm going to actually open up Firefox here to show true cross-browser. And this is an advertisement for Microsoft Surface, which you may have heard of recently, all built using Silverlight. We have some interesting interactivity elements, and we can go ahead and click on one of these videos and get more information about Surface in a very creative and interactive way. The possibilities of what you can do from an interactivity perspective, video perspective, media perspective, both advertising and web is very, very, very interesting. All right, now some information, data feeding down about the game. I can see what else is on, I get great video scaling. I can take this experience full screen if I'm very interested, but I still have all of the information overlaid. If I don't touch the mouse for a while, it'll fade out. We can jump out of that mode and go into just a full browser screen mode and start turning on some of these icons, the bases, my contacts, my player tracker for fantasy. And now, what's going to happen, if you look here in the bottom left, my friend, BigDoggo1, is going to send me a friend alert. He says, hey, Brian, I want you to look at a video. And when I click on this, I get, again, a picture-in-picture experience that's showing me a video clip that he shared with me. So bringing collaboration and interactivity to an online experience. That's very cool. But it gets even better when you think about situations where you can go outside the browser itself. So this is an example of a prototype, a future look at potentially what we can do with Silverlight for mobile devices. And this is an experience that was built by Major League Baseball, working with Frog Design and Design, both the mobile app and the desktop app. And we have the games that are live right now. We can drill into a specific game and actually see real-time data flowing down, showing us what's happening in the Chicago Cubs game here, where we see a ball is thrown, there's a base hit, see the players move and get the information. But we all care about fantasy baseball, right? That is what we want. We want to track our players. We have a player tracker built in. But what's amazing here is for the players that have interesting events happen, like A-Rod here, we can drill in and see a live feed or a recorded feed of a video of A-Rod, unfortunately, hitting a grand slam walk-off here by possibilities of what you can do with Silverlight on the desktop and Silverlight on the mobile device as an interactive platform for your customers is quite incredible.